Now, let's look at the service client. We see again, we have all the required imports. And here, we have the client definition. What we do here is, we first wait for the required service to become available. Then, we create a service proxy to be able to call the service. And here, we actually call the service. And we return the resulting response from the service call. Then, in the main function, we have the ROS node for the service client. We then have a test value of distance in meters that we will send to the server via this client. And once we have a response, we will check if the conversion was successful, and depending on that, we will report a log message accordingly. Notice here that we are using the logerr function, which is a log type, to report error messages. All right then, let's run the service server and client now. We first start ROS core, then we run the ROS node for the service server after sourcing our setup files. As you can see, the service is now available. Now, let's start the service client using ROS run. And there you have it. We see what we requested, and we see the result. One important thing we learned about services is that they block execution. So, let's see that as well. Since the processing of a service request happens in the server, let's go there and add a test loop which just adds a 10-second delay in the server. We do it like this. And on the client side, let's write a log message after the service call, which indicates we can get to that point in code only after the service call is completed. That is, until the blocking loop in the service server is done, we cannot get to this log message here. So, we start our server again, and then we start the client. We see first that the service call is being processed, and also any execution on the client side, like printing the log message, and the rest of the results of the service are all held up for 10 seconds because the service execution is not complete yet on the server side. So, this concludes the module on ROS services. Thank you.